everybody! I am NicoD. Today I'm very happy to review a USB3 camera that I've gotten from Egon Systems. So they delivered this to me. I follow this company for a long time. They make incredible products. They are based in India and they make a lot of camera solutions, but also some system on a modules. So those are modules that you can put on a baseboard. So it's exactly like an SBC. So other companies can make cameras with that, security cameras, anything you want with a camera. So these cameras are not cheap. I have gotten a 5 megapixel camera. I am filming myself here with it and I will try to show it. Here is the camera. So this is with USB Type-C, so USB 3. This camera is 5 megapixels, so up to 1944p. So this is more than 1080p, of course, a little less than 2K. But the image quality of this is really awesome. It is incomparable with any other camera of this kind, of course. I am now filming myself with my most expensive action camera, an SJCAM SJ8 Pro. This camera costs more than $200. So the quality of both are exactly the same, I think, for me. They are really, really very good. This camera has got a fixed lens, so you can choose yourself if you want to use it as a magnifier or if you want to choose to film a wide angle. I now have set the lens for my comfort for 1 meter or so. The advantage of a fixed lens is that it doesn't need to autofocus, so you always have a clear picture whatever you do. This camera, its main advantage is that it does very well in low lights. So yesterday evening I've tried it. It was totally dark outside. I put all my lights out. Only my displays from my computer were on. Nothing else from light was here and you could still see very nice colors. I will show you that. So I will show you the website of their company. I will show you a bit more of the camera. I will show you how it works in Linux and how it works in Windows. So here we go. So first let's check out their websites. You will quickly know why I love this company. So for that I type in Egon Systems and here it is. So they also make cameras for the Nvidia Jetson Nano. I will show you that. So here are the USB cameras. So they make a lot of USB cameras. Here is mine, the 5 megapixel low noise camera. But they make a lot more cameras than that. Also now with a camera with microphone. Mine doesn't have a microphone, but I've got enough microphones, so that is no problem for me. So they also make cameras with autofocus. And even stereo cameras. Those are cameras to film in 3D. So these are really great. This is awesome. Here is my camera. So here are the specs of the camera. So that is the maximum resolution it can film. And it can film at 60 frames per second with all these resolutions. They also have got a case for it, but I don't have that case. Too bad. So here are the system on modules. So this is a module with the Nvidia Tegra K1. This has got an incredible performance. This is comparable with the Nvidia Jetson Nano, but the CPU is even faster. This has got a quad-core Cortex A15 up to 2.2 GHz and a Kepler GPU of 192 CUDA cores. And here is the baseboard for it. So you can plug the SOM on there and use it as a normal SBC. So here are their Nvidia cameras. So this is their camera for the Jetson Nano. So it's MIPI. But they've got a lot more. So this, for example, is a contraption of 4 13 megapixel cameras combined. This is some very heavy duty stuff. So these cameras are more than 4K, so up to 3120p each. In Linux it is very easy to use this camera. There are no drivers needed, you just have to plug it. So here I am in the dev folder. It's not plugged in right now, so there is no video zero. So I'm gonna plug it in now. and you see video 0 has appeared. So now you can use it in any Linux application that can use a camera. So the camera name is just dev/video0. So I am going to use GUVCView to preview the camera. So the NanoPi M4 doesn't do great. It doesn't have hardware encoding enabled. So everything is done by the CPU. That means the frame rate is rather low, but there are a lot of settings you can mess with. So here is at 1080p, so it has 15 frames per second, even a bit better. I also tried it with the Odroid N2 and it performed exactly the same as the NanoPi M4. Of course, the Nvidia Jetson Nano would have been a lot better to use this camera. And here's some incredible stupid faces you can make with it. With Windows it's just the same, I just have to plug it in and open the Windows camera application and it works. Then now the low light condition, so I'm using the Raspberry Pi camera. Version 2, I'm also using my action camera and the Econ Systems C3 camera CU55. So here is the action camera. You can clearly see the Econ camera does a lot better, has a lot cleaner picture, has a lot less noise, even with those counter lights. The Raspberry Pi camera does very bad with these low light conditions. Of course, there is an infrared camera for the Raspberry Pi, but that infrared camera doesn't show colors. So here it is really dark. Here the Raspberry Pi, you can see barely nothing. Maybe you can see my hands moving, but I don't see much. Yeah, there's my face. I am very good at doing stupid. So my action camera doesn't do that bad, but you see it is very dark with my action camera. With this camera it is just a lot better. And there is a lot of noise with my action camera too. While my action camera should be made for low light conditions too. So one last look at the camera. So this camera contains two boards, one with the camera image sensor and the other with the USB3 interface. The camera chip is an AR0521, but the most important thing on it is the onboard signal processor. You can have the best camera sensor you want, if you don't have a good signal processor, you are nothing with your camera. It is the megapixels that says how good the image quality is. You can see that with my action camera, it has got a higher pixel density, but the video quality is worse than this camera. And then I even didn't show my cheaper action cameras. Those are a lot worse than this one. So now then my conclusion. All I can say is I'm very impressed with this camera. It has got a very good picture quality. It's the best camera that I have. You cannot compare this with any other camera like the Raspberry Pi cameras or the NanoPi cameras. Those just can't reach this quality. But of course these cameras are not made for the normal public. They are made for companies to put them into their products, into their finished products. So for security cameras and anything that involves a camera. I hope they will make it easier for the normal public to buy these cameras because we can use them in our SBC worlds. The Nvidia Jetson Nano would have been perfect with this camera. It would have no problem with any resolution, but my SBCs of course are not made for it. But things will change for that. I will keep an eye on this and I will make more videos about cameras and SBCs in the future. Next week I am going on vacation. I will take this camera with me to film myself at night in my tent. So I will go for 3 weeks to Great Britain. So I will again make YouTube videos. I hope you all will be watching. Thank you all for watching. See you later. Bye.